Hey, how are you? So I'm just changing the format of the series a bit, and I want to know, do you have what it takes to become an MVP? You know, over the past year, I've not missed a week, I've provided a video of interviews with various MVPs and kind of their view across 10 questions that I was asking. So I think now it's time to change the format a bit and really add my perspective on what it takes to become an MVP. So I'm aiming to teach you, show you, basically from my experience of 8 years of being an MVP, what I see works, what doesn't work, and hopefully you'll be able to glean some insights and decide whether becoming an MVP is for you. I want to leave you with this thought from Rick McCutcheon. Rick McCutcheon's an MVP from Canada, and he said to me, because I said to him, like, how do you define, or what's the best way to consider, should one become an MVP? And he said this. He said, if you only work your job 9 to 5, in other words, you just go along, eat your lunch, collect your salary, and you really could pivot into any other career at the drop of the hat, it's not worth becoming an MVP. But if you see this as your career, that you want to develop, that you want to become an expert, a guru, if you like, in this space, then you should do everything it takes to become an MVP, because the value it'll add to your career is really more than what you could expect. So, I'm going to do a series here, as I said, so you'll want to hear more about what I'm going to cover. Like, subscribe, ask any questions, comment below, and I'll aim to answer your questions in a future video. Ciao for now.